Here's another daily workout you can do every day. Three different exercises with a bunch of modifications. This way you can select what best fits your body. So Mariska's gonna start here up against the wall. Get the hips all the way up against the wall. So a few things we wanna think about. Her head is going to be up against the wall. Her cervical spine is not. It's going to be in that slight arch. Her thoracic spine, so basically here to about here, should be up against the wall or as close as you can. The lumbar spine should be slightly arched off, and the tush should be on the wall. Depending on the size of your tush, that might affect what touches the wall. Now, I'm gonna have Mariska walk her feet about a foot distance away from the wall. Beautiful. Take your right leg back up against the wall. Now, there might be some balance issues. That's why we have Mariska in the corner, so she can put her hand up against the wall if need be. So the other challenge is getting that foot all the way up against the wall, okay? If you have some limited dorsiflexion or tightness in the back of the leg, that might be limited, okay? So from here, her heel is pressing down. Before doing anything, lift your arms, Mariska, and just push your foot into the wall. Don't lift the hips yet. Just push the foot into the wall and resist your own movement. Good. Can you feel the back of your leg heating up? So that might be it. You might just do an isometric hold, okay? The second modification is bring your arms down, Mariska, and you're going to push your entire body off the wall by just using that leg. And be careful because the foot might slip. Good. Yep. And then slowly back. So the hardest part is the eccentric contraction back. So that's why we have her pretty close to the wall. Even if she kind of falls back into it, the wall is going to save her. Good. Hold it here. Now, lift the arms up and keep the arms lifted as you slowly go back. So we're getting hip flexion on the leg that's up against the wall and hip extension on the way out. Good. Again, this looks really simple, but as Mariska can tell you, it is not easy. Switch to the other leg. Now, Mariska, which is your stronger side?
Right.
Her right leg is her stronger side. So balancing on that left leg would be a challenge. Now, although she doesn't have as much strength on her left leg, the support of the right leg will give her some assistance. So first, just arms lifted and push the foot into the wall. Good. And again, we might stop the exercise here. Another modification, arms down or up and pushing the whole body off. Good, and slowly back down. Good. So if you can see on the video, Mariska's pushing up really nicely and has good support on this right hip, but that eccentric load on the hamstring on the back is a little bit more challenging, but looks pretty good to me. Do one more. Good, and relax. Beautiful. After that, Mariska's gonna come back onto the mat over here in a quadruped position, so that's on all fours. The hardest part of this exercise is going to be getting in the position. The first order of business is I'm going to check Mariska's scapulas. So right now, the top of her scapula, spine of her scapula, is much closer than the bottom. So I'm going to ask her to bring the bottoms of the scapulas closer, okay? I want her to be about 3 inches away from either side of her spine. From here, that corrects her humeral heads right from jump. Now from here, I like her ribs a little heavier in her scapula. So take a big inhale and exhale. And just keep in mind, when I'm cueing her ribs, my intention is to get her thoracic spine in the right place, not just jamming her ribs up. So hold this, Mariska, and I'm just gonna check, give me a little more arch in the lumbar. Okay, a little, can you move that vertebra a little more? Yeah, much harder. So from here, I'm gonna ask her to hold this spinal position. Tuck your toes under if they aren't already and lift your knees an inch. Beautiful. Can you squeeze the scapulas together a little bit? And now breathe the ribs up into the scapulas. This should be very challenging. Again, Mariska's got slight shakes going on, which means she's doing it correctly. If you're not, two things, check your scapular position or this curve of your spine. Lower the knees down for a minute. Good. Now, from here, I'm going to ask her to stay in the same position and give me a cat back or a flexed spine. Now, what will happen is people will flex where it's easiest. So I'm going to ask her to flex her cervical a little more by bringing her chin towards her throat. And can you give me a little more tail between the legs? A little bit less from here and a little more from there. I'm gonna give her feedback. Now, if you don't have me at home, just think about getting the spots that are a little tighter to move. Now, feet are tucked under, lift the knees an inch. Now, see if you can tuck the tail between the legs and give you a little more lumbar flexion. Good. And a little more flexion into this. So I'm gonna give her 2 points to push into me. And she's gonna hate me in about 2 seconds. Good, and relax. Beautiful. One more option, you still with me? Now, if you notice, Mariska's got her hands on either side here because that's better for her wrists. But if you can, bring your hands underneath your shoulders. If this is available, make it available. It becomes challenging when you can't keep your humeral head in the joint. So the option is to turn your hands out like she did. So go back where you were. I just wanted to bring that attention. Good. So holding this position here, give downward rotation of scapulas. Let's keep a neutral spine here and lift the knees an inch. Now, I want you to do a pelvic clock in this position. If you had a tail, think about waving it in a circle. Or if you had a laser beam shooting out the back end, draw a circle with it. Good. And go the opposite direction. And if you feel absolutely ridiculous when you're doing it, you're probably doing it right. Good. And relax down. Sit back on your heels, take a little break. Nice. I would take a good break between each one of those because they should be very challenging to do. All right? I kind of just made her go through. Come on back to the corner. The last thing is another standing exercise. If you've done any boxing classes, it's called shadow boxing. If you have little hand weights, you can use those. But what Marissa's going to do, she's going to get in a wide stance into a bit of a squat. So go externally rotated with your legs. There you go. Perfect. And just give yourself a little squat. Good. Bring your hands up. And now all she's going to do without rotation, just punch across with the right and the left. So what's actually happening in this shoulder? So hold the next one. She's actually turning her wrist from her elbow, keeping the humeral head in the joint. Now that sounds easy, but it is not. So come back and keep going. Think about that rotation in the hand coming just from the elbow. Good, and now pick up the speed a little bit, Mariska. Good, and now add a little bit of thoracic rotation, thinking your nipple towards the opposite to the same armpit. Good, and rotate, 10, 9, 8, 7, making sure she's not moving too low yet. 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Now, it is not wrong to rotate lower on your spine. Our goal of that exercise was to get the thoracic spine to rotate. You can take that into full rotation as long as you have the thoracic spine working. To make this exercise more difficult, hand weights, or you can punch a bag. Thanks, Mariska.